enots engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video we make 5 T-nuts to fit the CNC machine. These are specially made to suit the aluminium extrusion on the CNC machine. All the milling is done in the lathe, so let's go into the workshop, see how we make them. Today in the workshop I want to make some T-nuts from a CNC machine, and what I'm using is aluminium that I cut out of the machine back plate. See, I cut these shapes out, so I've got lots of these aluminium triangles. I've marked this one out, and I cut it in the bandsaw and make some T-nuts for the bed of the CNC. I'll do the milling on the lathe. So the first thing I need to do is set the tool post parallel to the chuck. And what I'm doing is holding my dial indicator across the jaws to clamp it. This means I can move the dial indicator up and down to get it in the right position. You don't need to clamp it tight in the jaws, just enough to hold it. Bring it into the tool post, and then by adjusting the tool post you can set this to run true. It's about 1/4 over that length. That's a couple of tenths. The aluminium I've using has got, that's been sawn off just on the bandsaw that side, and that's got another saw cut on that side, so I want to make one side square. I'm just using a piece of packing on the top so that I don't damage the surface of the aluminium with the locking cap heads. Just lock that in position. What I want to do next is put the fly cutter in the chuck, and I'll just adjust the height of this so the aluminium is near the centre of the chuck. It's not critical, it's just so that the fly cutter cuts evenly each side. Just check that I can move the full length of that piece of aluminium and that the cutting bit will travel right to the end. That's at the end of my travel. That should be okay. Change the fly cutter to an end mill with 4 flutes. So I've roughed it out, now I can get a better finish on there.
I've set the aluminium to the centre of the cutter.
Now what I've done is I've changed my tool holder to one that holds a wider tool. This was the original one I was using. As you can see, I can't get this piece of aluminium in sideways, but I can on this one. I've put some packing at the back to bring it out 3 millimeters, so when I go 3 mil deep it'll miss this tool holder. And I've put a smaller diameter end mill in, so it only comes up 6.25 millimeters, which is the depth I need to go. So what I need to do now is machine that until it's 3 millimeters deep, turn the part round and do the same on the other side, and that should give me the width I need in the middle.
Now I need to reduce the thickness by 1 millimetre, so I fitted it in a 4-jaw chuck and I'm facing off the part.
Now after taking off some of the sharp edges, that slides in there. So all I need to do now is drill and tap 6mm holes and then slice them off into the nuts.
I fitted the blank for the T-nuts in the pedestal drill vise and I've marked out, I'll get 5 T-nuts out of this, and I'll position the centre drill in the centre this way and in the centre for the first hole for the first nut. So what I'm going to do is centre drill all the positions, change it to a 5mm drill and then drill through all the holes. Now the way I centre and position the parts is I've got fitted to my drill press table an X and Y axis so I can position the part anywhere within this area. It's a little heavy for this drilling machine, but it seems to be coping with it. So now I have to wind it over 3/4 of an inch. That's a finished item. Now on this one, when I tighten this bolt up and clamp something on it, the top of the T-nut doesn't protrude over the top of the bed.
Five new T-nuts. Well, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.